the superhero subgenre has taken over pop culture. 4 of the 10 highest-grossing films of all time come from Marvel. Superhero shows are winning new awards every year. And superhero video games let you play as Batman himself. But behind everything, one man stands at the roots of the superhero industry.
Hi, I'm the Final Boss. That's my name. My favorite hero is Spider-Man. Probably Lex Luthor. My favorite movie of all time is probably Back to the Future. Ooh, favorite show, Twilight Zone. All time? Spider-Man. Right now, too many to choose from. Rogues is pretty awesome right now. Favorite game of all time would be Legacy of Kain Soul Reaver. That's a cut right there. Most influential comic. I want to go back to Spidey. I mean, it's a regular guy, you know, always tries to do the right thing. People hate him for no reason, has bills, problems, and he just keeps doing the right thing. Why should people read books instead of just sticking to shows and movies? There's so much more in the comics. Plus, with shows and movies, you have to wait forever, where comics are out every week. And new stories, new adventures, things that will never hit the big screen. I've done so many jobs, and I always come back to this. I've been running this store for 15 years overall, and I've run schools, I've worked for large video game companies, I've done marketing, but it always comes back to this. This is the best job in the world. No, it's never work. It's definitely more. It's just, I read almost every book that comes in a store every week, so it's just so many new adventures, things I may have never picked up or noticed if I didn't run this place. No, not really. I mean, generally, people who come in here, they come in here to not be in a bad mood. It's like Cheers. They come in here just to, you know, forget about their rough days and have fun. Oh, so many stories to choose from. I mean, there's been so many adventures in these last 15 years of just customers coming in, not knowing each other one day, then the next day, everyone's chatting with each other. One story I can think of is when I first opened, I got a call for someone asking for a Punisher book. And I put it to the side for him, and he pulls up, and he looks like it's Floyd? And it's a person I've known for, I knew him for 15 years at the time, and we reunited through comics. I am. I'm actually in 2 issues, thanks to the wonderful G. Willow Wilson. It's right here in the second trade, available at Final Boss Comics, located at 10 Gordon Avenue in Lawrenceville, New Jersey.
I'm gonna put like a logo here.
Cheap pop. But yes, I'm actually in the issue, even though she changed my name to Roy in Roy's Comics and Games. But it's great. It's great because she made Miss Marvel the Jersey City superhero, where I'm originally from. And yeah, it was a great time.
How'd you meet her?
We basically called her in to do a book signing when Miss Marvel came out. I mean, Miss Marvel being the Jersey City superhero, it was, at the time, the most popular book out. It was outselling tons of books. And she went to Kohl's Academic, and my store was on Kohl's Street at the time. So, boom. It was the perfect shop for her to shop at, since Miss Marvel went to the school down the block, which is really McNair High School. Akira.
I agree.
Shut up. You shouldn't have said that.
Definitely not Akira.
Okay, what would we ask that one?
I'm
Kingdom Come, Watchmen.
I don't know. It's like Akira. You don't start with one of those. You can, but you don't.
But like as an introduction, like getting people into reading comics.
It all depends on what they like. Some people start with Dog Man. Some people start with Captain Underpants.
I started with Teeny Titans.
Teeny Titans, see?
Teeny Titans, good.
Start comics wherever you feel the way in is. I always tell people when they come in, what shows do you watch? What movies do you like? And then I try to modify their taste to that. That way it matches. If people come in who like horror movies, I suggest horror comics to them. There's so many of them out. If you like action movies, there's tons of action comics. If you like superheroes, there's always superhero comics. But that's the beautiful thing about comic books. There's something for everyone. And if you're not into comics, I mean, there's always board games, video games, Funko Pops. There's something for everyone. So my original store, I had a Final Destination moment where it was a really windy day back in October 2008, and the wind blew down a tree, which missed me. The tree hit the power lines. The power lines swung over my head as I dived into the store. It set the store on fire, and me and the customers ran out. So I lost, unfortunately, everything in there, but thankfully I had insurance, and I reopened a few blocks down at a different location about a week later. Period 7A. Come on down. No, come look at some books. Thank Robert, I guess, for making you sit through this video the same way I'm sitting through it or standing through it. And I don't know, just have fun. Whatever you do, have fun.
I wasn't recording. You gotta give me a heads up.